Hello, my name is Wumping. Today, I'll be going through level 13 to 18 of the Over the Wire Bandit Wargame series. If you have not watched my walkthrough from level 0 to 12 yet, you can find the links in the description below. Alright, let's get started. For level 13, the password is stored in /etc/bandit_pass/bandit14, and this can only be read by the Bandit14 user. Now, this is a very important new information because it will affect your solution for other levels. Something different about level 13 is that you will be provided a private SSH key but not the password. Run ls-l to view the content on your home directory. Run cat sshkey.private to view the content of the file. Well, looks like this is the private SSH key to access level 14. To perform SSH login using a private key like this, you can make use of the -i flag to provide the identity file. Now that you are logged in as Bandit 14, you can retrieve the level 14 password from /etc/bandit_pass/bandit14. There you go. This is the password to go to level 14 directly without using the private SSH key. Something worth noting about this level is that it is an introduction to the public key cryptography. To put it in layman terms, this method of performing authentication makes use of two different keys, a private key and a public key. The reason you can directly log in to Bandit 14 using the private key is because its public key is already set up previously. It can be used as a form of authentication method because, as the name suggests, it is private to the user and it is something that only the user should own and no one else. For level 14, the password can only be retrieved by submitting the current level password to port 30,000 on localhost. As mentioned in the previous level goal, localhost is a host name that refers to the machine you are working on. To solve this challenge, you can make use of netcat. Netcat is a command that allows you to read or write data via a network connection. It is very handy for banner grabbing or in this case, to connect to a specific port to perform an action. There you go, this is the password to go to level 15. In circumstances when there is no netcat on the host, you can also use telnet to achieve the same result. For level 15, the password can only be retrieved by submitting the current level password to port 30,001 on localhost using SSL encryption. Well, the only difference between this and the previous level is that this level requires SSL encryption, so we cannot just use netcat or telnet like before. To solve this challenge, you can make use of OpenSSL's S-Client implementation. OpenSSL is a library for secure communication over network, and OpenSSL's S-Client is the implementation of a simple client. It can be used to establish connection to a server using SSL or TLS. There you go, this is the password to go to level 16. For level 16, the password can only be retrieved by submitting the current level password to one of the ports on localhost in the range between 31,000 to 32,000. Now, this is similar to the previous two levels, but instead of having a specific port given to you to interact with, this time you need to find the port by yourself. To solve this challenge, as hinted in the level goal, You need to complete 3 tasks. Let's do it together. Task number 1 is to find out which are the ports that has a server listening on them. To do this, you have to make use of a port scanner, which is a tool that can be used to identify open ports on a server. On every server, there are 65535 TCP IP ports. For example, you are currently logged in to the Bandit host via port 2220. The most popular port scanner that I am aware of is nmap. It is a very popular port scanner tool which is well liked by folks in the industry, and it has been around for a very long time. As shown in the nmap scan results, there are 5 open ports. Now, let's do task number 3 first, which is to find out which server will not simply send back to you whatever you sent to it. You can do it easily by using echo. Echo basically just print the provided string onto the standard output. So, when we pipe the output into netcat like this, the string test will be sent to the specific port. As you can see, only the services at port 31518 and 31790 did not simply send back the same input to you. This means that one of them is the service that will return the password to go to level 17. Remember, in the previous level, you were introduced to the OpenSSL S client implementation? We will be using it now to solve task number 2, which is to find out which ones among them communicates in SSL. As shown, when communicating in SSL, port 31518 also simply returns you the same string that you sent to it. Looks like port 31790 is the correct port, as it has returned with a private key when provided with the password for the current level. Now, create a directory to store the private SSH key so you can use it to log in to the next level. Permission has been denied because it is currently too open. To solve this, simply use change mod 400 to make it so that only the file owner has access to read it but not write or execute it. For group or others access, there is no permission to read, write or execute. There you go, now you are logged in to level 17. For level 17, the password is the only line that has been changed between a passwords.old and a passwords.new file. Note that if you see a bye-bye text when trying to log in to level 18, it is an expected behavior as it is related to the challenge for the next level. Run ls-l to verify that the two password files are in your home directory. To solve this level, you can make use of the diff command. The diff command allows you to compare files line by line. There you go, this is the password to go to level 18. To verify the password, you can try to log in to level 18 via SSH. As shown, the bye-bye message is printed and you have been logged out as expected. For level 18, the password is stored in README, which is located in the home directory. Unfortunately, someone has modified the .bashrc file to log you out whenever you try to log in via SSH. .bashrc is a file that will be run every time your terminal is loaded. In this case, when you log in via SSH, it is considered as a terminal tool, therefore the content in .bashrc will be loaded as well. Since SSH is the only login method available to you, you should find out if you can do anything before getting constantly logged out because of the .bashrc file. Here's the thing, wherever the --help of any tools does not provide you with sufficient useful information that you are looking for, you can always run man and then the tool's name. This allows you to view the system's manual regarding the tool, like this. As you can see over here, the -t flag can force pseudo terminal allocation, which can be used to execute arbitrarily screen-based programs on a remote machine. Let us try to log in again, but this time with the -t flag to run cat README. There you go, this is the password to go to level 19. With this, I have come to the end of my step-by-step walkthrough of Over the Wire Bandit Wargame series for level 13 to 18. I hope this detailed walkthrough has been useful to you in your learning and help you understand the new concepts that were being introduced. Learning cybersecurity can be fun. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Stay tuned for more videos in the series.